Let's start connecting this NetBeans into our MySQL database. To do so, we need a library file, jar file. So let's go to libraries and add the jar file. So I already downloaded this. We need this one, MySQL connector Java. So I will put the link in the description so you can download the same and add the library file. You can see this is added now here. Once it is added, we can start coding for the connection. So let's start with creating a class. So I'll create a class or function, then wherever we require the database connection, we can call the same function there. So public class db connect, then public class public static connection connect. Okay, so inside the parenthesis we will use the connection string. Connection connect is equal to null. So let's import the parent class for connection. Import java.sql.connection. Now class.forName, inside the parenthesis let's do com.mysql.jdbc.driver. Then connection is equal to connection driver manager dot git connection. So inside this parenthesis you can put the connection string like jdbc colon mysql colon double slash. Here if your localhost, your database in localhost, put localhost. If it is in remote, put the remote address here. Localhost colon, then port address of your MySQL database. By default, it will be 3306 slash database name. In my case, it is sample. Then username is root and password is nothing in my case. So you can change accordingly. Yes. Also driver manager, let's import the parent class here. Import java.sql.driver manager. Now let's see what is the error. Let's surround the block with try catch. Let's take it out of the try catch block. Return connection is missing, so let's add the return statement. It's done. Now our class is ready. So whenever we require the database connection, we can call the class. So in this case, when we click this submit button, we need database to be connected. So we can insert some values to database when they click the submit button, or we can retrieve some values from the database. So let's call the function that database db connect first. To do so, create a connection string. Connection one con one is equal to null, and connection one db connect. So we call the function. Now statement stmt is equal to connection one dot create statement. If connection one is equal to null, so what it means? It means we are not connected to database. So J option pane will display us unable to connect database or some message. So you can modify the code accordingly if you want to insert into the database or you are retrieving from the database. So that's up to you. I hope this video is helpful to you. Thank you for watching.